Welcome to the TASCAM Model 12. In this video, we will show the basic instructions on setting up the Model 12 as a control surface for your digital audio workstation. This video is specifically for Cubase. If you don't have Cubase, see the other videos for your particular DAW. Connect the Model 12 USB cable to your computer. Model 12 uses a USB-C connector. Some modern computers will also have a USB-C connector. This computer we are using today has a USB-A connector, so the cable we need is this common USB-C to USB-A cable. Make sure the cable supports USB 2 or higher. Next, put the input mode switch on PC, or in the middle position of the Model 12, for channels 1 and 2. You can set the other channels however you choose. The first thing to do is download the Model Mixer Setting Panel software from TASCAM.com. This is found on the Downloads tab on the individual Model 12 product page. Go ahead and install the Model Mixer Setting Panel software. Now it's time to put Model 12 into DAW controller mode. Press the menu button. The multi-jog knob uses a turn and push method. Once you highlight a function, you can then push the knob to select it. Turn the multi-jog knob until you get to the DAW controller. Push the multi-jog knob to select DAW controller. Model 12 has presets for the most popular DAWs, so highlight Mackie Cubase and press the multi-jog knob to select it. The Model 12 will ask you if you are sure and want to start the controller mode. Press the far right button directly under the display or yes. Model 12 displays a notice that only track channels 1 and 2 can be used as the default for Cubase. Press the multi-jog knob, enter. The Model 12 is now in controller mode and its faders and most of its knobs are disabled to the internal Model 12 functions. TASCAM cannot provide customer support for your software program, computer, or computer configuration. Here are the settings on this computer, which is a MacBook Pro using Cubase LE. The first thing we need to do is set up Cubase to use the Model 12 as its USB audio interface. We click Studio on the top here on Cubase, and we choose Studio Setup. The first thing to click is VST Audio System, which I just did here. And under the ASIO driver here, click that, and there's several selections, and we need to choose the Model 12. It says, would you like to switch? Yes, we'll switch. The next thing we need to do is set up the protocol between the Model 12 and Cubase to make Model 12 the control surface. That's a MIDI port setup function. So I click MIDI port setup. I click the plus sign upper left here. And what you want to choose is the Mackie control. And that's the protocol that the Model 12 will send to Cubase that Cubase will understand so Model 12 can be the control surface. So choose Mackie control. That's done. Here, the MIDI input is not connected. I click that. I would like to choose the Model 12. The MIDI output, I'll choose the Model 12. I'll hit OK. Now everything is done. Now that we have that set up, you can see that the faders are live. The pan pots work. The master volume works fine. The transport control, let's hit play. Let's hit stop. Let's fast forward. Rewind. And even the scroll dial on the Model 12 scrolls through the file. The default is to control tracks 1 through 8 on your DAW. This screen is the marker set screen. This is where you can set markers on your DAW by pressing the set button underneath the display while the file plays. To control tracks 9 through 16, press the menu button on the Model 12. The Model 12 will display track. Then press the arrow to the right button under the display, and DAW tracks 9 through 16 are controlled. To control tracks 17 through 24, press the display arrow to the right again underneath the display. Now tracks 17 through 24 are controlled. To go back to tracks 9 through 16, or 1 through 8, press the display button to the left over and over, and tracks 9 through 16, or 1 through 8, are then controlled.